Hey bosses, welcome back to my channel. Today is going to be a special video. This is going to be me getting ready, doing my hair and my makeup. Yeah, I got a new unit. I haven't done my hair in a little minute, and all the details I'll leave down below, but this hair is from Glitzy Hair. I believe this is an 18 inch body wave and it's a closure unit, and I try my best to finesse it. I'm not a pro, I'm a beginner, but I made it work to the best of my ability. Now if you stay the 6 feet like we supposed to, I'm unclockable. But if you get too close, then that's a whole nother issue. But it looks super good, like, bitch. But yeah, I hope you enjoy this video. Make sure you subscribe, like, comment, follow me on my social medias, all that good stuff. And let's get straight into the video. And make sure you turn on your post notifications so you're notified every time your girl uploads a video. And I think that's it. So stay tuned. So I start off this video using calamine lotion. That's what's all over my face. And I use these two Revlon foundations. I'll leave the names down below because I can't remember off the top of my head. And I'm just applying this with the Real Techniques brush and applying this all over my face for a smooth, even finish. And make sure to blend so you can't blend no more, so it could be a flawless finish. So here I'm taking an orange color corrector and then just placing it between my eyebrows for whatever reasons. I probably had some dark marks there. Blending it out and then going over the foundation to cover up probably the acne scars that I had going on right there. And I'm over here jamming to some music, probably some soca. Make sure you just blend, and also blend down your neck. And then I'm using a little bit of the darker foundation to mix it together and using the brush. Then I go in with a sponge and actually blend it out more. And I'm going in with the orange color corrector to cover up the darkness of my mouth because the foundation is not full coverage. Now I'm going in with my concealer. This is by Juvia's Place. This is the I Am Magic Concealer. And I'm putting it under my eyes, forehead, and at the sides of my lip and blending it out with this sponge. And I'll link the sponge down below. I got it from a BoxyCharm box. And I wanted a little more highlighted look, so I took this concealer. I'm not sure the brand. I'll leave it down below. It's actually by It Cosmetics. It's the CC cream, and I'm putting it underneath my eyes and my forehead just to highlight. I actually didn't like this concealer, so I ended up just having to cover it with a setting powder. But this doesn't give me the coverage that I want. Then I'm taking this Sasha Cosmetics foundation color and I'm just taking a lighter shade to set my under eyes and the places that I highlighted. I didn't actually like this brush, so I end up switching to a smaller brush to get in between the creases. And I also took another brush to further make the powder more full coverage. But I ended up going in with the Sasha Buttercup Loose Setting Powder. I love this for underneath the eyes. And I'm taking a Real Techniques setting brush and applying it underneath my eyes. And I don't really bake. I kind of bake and then just wipe it off. I don't leave it on for too long. Now I'm going back into the Sasha palette, taking a darker color, like my skin color, and just setting the rest of my face. Then I'm going in with a darker color to bronze and warm up my cheeks, my jawline, my forehead, all that good stuff. And y'all know I go heavy-handed with the bronzer. Love it.
I love to bring the warmth back to my face instead of looking all flat. Then I'm going in with this blush from MAC and applying this to my cheeks. Then I'm blending in the bronzer, and I'm also using setting powder to make the line sharp because it was looking kind of messy, and I'm just going to blend that away with a brush. Then I'm going to go in and contour my nose and drag it into my crease. And I'm not too heavy-handed because I already like the shape of my nose, but just to give it some structure. Then I'm going in with this eyeshadow primer from Jessie's Girl. I got this on sale at Target, I believe, and I wanted to try it out. I mean, it does what it's supposed to do. Nothing amazing. But I'm just going to blend this in, and I'm going to deepen my crease with that bronzer color with a fluffy brush, and I'm going to just keep adding color to make it more intense. Then I'm going with a bigger brush to further blend out that bronzer color. I'm going back and forth with the two just to make sure it's blended and it doesn't look crazy. Then I'm taking this blush that I always use, the Always Spicy blush, just to put into my crease to give it that reddish hint to it. And I'm going to blend that in the crease as well. Then I'm going in with this pressed powder just to place on my lid so my lid doesn't get oily. I kind of like that skin color lid, if you understand what I'm saying. And I'm just going to blend that in, and that's it for the eyes. Then I'm going into the Jeffree Star highlighting palette and taking this pinkish highlight and applying it to the tops of my cheeks. And a little goes a long way with these highlighters. I absolutely love them. They are blinding. Then I'm going in and put it in the inner tear ducts, that same color. And I love a bright, shimmery inner tear duct color. Then I'm going in with this Everyday Vacay just to get rid of that powdery look on my face. Letting that dry. Then I'm going in with this House Labs eyeliner. And this eyeliner is very hard to use. Like, the slightest touch on your skin, it gets everywhere. So that's why I'm pulling my eyes taut. But I'm not doing it too tight where it's gonna mess up my eyes. But this eyeliner is kind of difficult to work with. If you're a beginner, I wouldn't really suggest this. I got this in a BoxyCharm, I believe. But I'm doing like a baby wing liner. Then I'm going in with mascara. This is the L'Oreal Telescopic Mascara, and I'm just applying this to my little baby eyelashes. Then I'm doing my lips. I'm taking this She palette. I got this from Shop Miss A. It's literally, I think, $3. I'm just taking the darker color to outline my lips. Then I take a medium tone color in the center. And then I wanted it to be a little bit lighter, so I took even a lighter color and put it in the middle just to give myself that juicy appearance. So I forgot to do my lashes, so here they are. Then I'm going to take these flexi rods out my hair. Got them from the beauty supply store. content on this hair is throughout my channel, so make sure you check that playlist. I'll link it down below if I can remember. I'm gonna just take it out, fluff it out, and then I'm making sure the lace looks good. So I'm taking my foundation powder and just putting it down the part, and taking this hop comb just to flatten out the top so it doesn't look too wiggy. And yes, bosses, this is the end of this quick everyday makeup tutorial. I hope you enjoyed. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.